Hi SD fans and welcome back. In this video we're continuing our holiday focus, this time looking at packing your hand luggage for your diving holiday. Now many divers have cameras and housings these days, as well as one or two dive computers, plus all the peripheral accessories, and we'll be giving you some hints and advice on the best ways to pack that I've honed from over 25 years of travelling around the world to diving destinations, as well as a sneaky tip that will help you avoid any overweight issues. For those here for the first time, my name's Mark, I'm the Editor-in-Chief of the Scuba Diver media brand, and welcome to the Scuba Diver YouTube channel. Remember to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any of our future videos, and ring that bell so you get notification of the latest releases. Don't forget to check out below how you can get a free digital subscription to any of our magazines. That's Scuba Diver UK, Scuba Diver Australia and New Zealand, and Scuba Diver Destinations, which is our US and Canada edition. And if you want to get your hands on a print version, we've got a special subscription deal for our YouTube followers as well. Now, let's dive into the video. As I said in our video about travelling with your dive equipment, packing all of your precious kit and ensuring it's as safe and secure as possible while trying to avoid being crucified by the increasingly restrictive luggage allowances and overweight baggage fees we seem to be getting these days is one of the most stressful aspects of a dive trip. However, if anything, packing your hand luggage is even more of a nightmare. When I used to head off on a diving holiday in the past, packing my hand luggage was a doddle. I just grabbed a rucksack, chucked in a book, my Sony Walkman and headphones, that tells you how long we're talking about, my passport, tickets, dive certs and my dive computer. There was probably a fleece in there too. That was it. If it tipped the scales at 3 to 4 kilograms, I'd be surprised. How things change. Now it's like a military operation packing my hand luggage. I have to get my MacBook Pro laptop, my charging cable, my camera, my housing, my port, strobes, battery charger, arms, dive computers, etc., as well as passport, dive certs, tickets, all into a small bag, which is then often limited to 7 kilograms or even less. It's a constant headache, but through a lot of trial and error over the years, I've now got 2 bags, which allow me to generally avoid any weight issues and still pack everything I need to get my assignment completed. If for any reason my main hole baggage, which has all my dive kit in it, goes missing or it's delayed, I can always use rental equipment and still get in the water to take the pictures. Now my go-to bag is this little roller bag. With everything I need in here for a standard assignment, it weighs in around 9.5 kilograms. However, thanks to its dinky little dimensions, I think I've only been asked once in about 400 flights to put it on the scales. It just doesn't look like it'd hold any more than 6 or 7 kilograms. When asked if I have hand luggage, I just hold this up and then they generally hand over a cabin bag to put on the grab handle. Sorted. I prefer to use a roller bag over a rucksack, as if you're wandering around a terminal or you have lengthy stopovers en route to and from your destination, it's far more comfortable and easier towing one of these around. Now, let's go through the packing. Now, many of these bags have loads of pockets, etc., but I find this only increases the bulk, and with it, the chances of having the bag weighed. This one is very basic. It's got a small zippered pocket on the top. This is where I put my dive certs and my passport. And then it has a larger pocket below, which I put my headphones in, and then that's also where I put my wallet and my phone, etc., when I'm on the plane. It then has just this one big zippered compartment, and into there goes everything else. Now I put the fiber optic cables and the strobe cables and any charge up cables into here, because that way they're all in one place and secure. The zipper died a long time ago, but the pocket still does what it needs to do. I then put my housing in first, followed by the 2 strobes. Now around these, I put the dome port and the camera itself, which I wrap in bubble wrap as a little bit of added protection. Into the spaces around this, I put the charging adapters and the battery chargers. They all fit in there nicely. Primary dive computer goes in there. And I also put my glasses case for my sunglasses in as well. Now with all those in there, there's not a lot of room, so it stops everything shifting around. So it's all quite nice and secure. I then put a piece of bubble wrap in, and I put the arms for my housing in there. Lastly, get my laptop into its padded case, and that sits in on top of everything. So then, once that's in there, and I zip it up, everything is nice and secure and won't fall down when it's stood up. And if I have to show it when I'm in security, I can just flip open the top and I can just grab my laptop out and show it in the security. If I actually get pulled at security, as I'm sure underwater photographers will be very familiar with, I can just flip open that top compartment, take that out, remove these, everything is clear and easy to see. Now, like I said before, that's how I pack. It's not the only way to pack, but it works for me. And it keeps everything nice and secure. If I know I'm going to be travelling on an airline which is extremely tight on hand luggage, then I'll defer to a lightweight rucksack. And this will save me a few kilos over the roller bag. In this instance, it's a Scuba Pro one. My rule of thumb about not having bags with logos on, etc., doesn't really apply to hand luggage, as I'll always have this with me. Now, I like this Scuba Pro bag because it has a main compartment which will take down all of my housing, strobes, camera, dive computer, etc., and then the charging cables and everything go in this secondary compartment. The laptop neatly goes into its own section on the back. This is very secure because when you're wearing it, this sits against your back. And two, when you need to get your laptop out of security, just undo these zippers, pull it out right there. My passport goes into this little front pocket. Now, it's not as easy to pack with all of my paraphernalia in this bag, I have to be honest. A wide open compartment, as on the roller bag, is far easier to safely and securely pack your precious gear. But if I employ a few of my t-shirts from out of my main bag as extra padding, wrapping the strobes, port and camera in one each, I've never had any issues. Now, if I was using a rucksack more often, I would probably try and find a lightweight version of those Photo Pro ones, where the entire front opens up very similar to my roller bag, and then you have compartments padded with foam for each piece of equipment. However, as I mainly use the roller bag, I can make do with this Scuba Pro one for the time being. One thing I do like about it is this strap. This slides over the handle, the retractable handle on my StarSat roller bag, makes it nice and easy to roll about the airport in one piece of luggage. I can usually pack this rucksack and keep it under 7 kilograms. But if you're on one of those flights where hand luggage is prohibitively tight, we're talking 5 kilograms or less, then you need to bring in a trick I picked up from traveling with some seasoned underwater photographers. You need a photographer's ghillie, which is festooned with cavernous pockets. If you're in a situation where you know your hand luggage is going to be weighed and that it is going to tip the scales at several kilos over the limit, then you can stash strobes, chargers, camera bodies, etc. in these pockets when you check in. Your hand luggage will then come in under a required limit, and once you're away from the check-in desk, you can safely pack all of your gear out of your jacket and back into your hand luggage, ready to go through security. Sneaky, but it works. I even saw one jacket that they'd sewn a pocket into the back that could take a laptop. What are some of your hints and advice for packing your hand luggage? Any neat tricks to pass on to your fellow divers? Leave your comments below, and if you have a question, fire away. We can't answer it, maybe someone in our community will be able to. Remember, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and don't forget, you can grab a free digital magazine in the description below. As always, stay safe, and if you're one of the lucky people who live somewhere you are able to get out and dive, enjoy.